basketball fans, welcome to the Red Zone. As we are getting ready for, a triple header of basketball action here tonight on Hicksville Community Television, boys basketball, and it is the Bryan Golden Bears in town. We are getting ready to tip off the first game here at the Red Zone this afternoon. That will be the freshman matchup, and that will be followed by junior varsity and varsity basketball action. We're going to be here for all three games, so you'll be able to catch coverage of all three of the contests here on Hicksville Community Television. Connor Pellin, number 12 for the Golden Bears, set to jump against Braden Langham, wearing number 14 for the Aces. We'll fill in numbers and names as we go along. The tip controlled by the Golden Bears, and we are underway. Jim Seiler here with us, too. I started off the coverage because Jim was finishing jotting down a few last-minute changes to the roster from the scorer's table.
So we're okay now.
Yeah, so now we're... now we're going to know just what's going on.
Right. Number 20, Zuber, hits a 15-footer, 4-2 for Bryan. Aces being pressed. Get the ball across the 10-second line. Tunis with the 2 points.
Well, if he plays like his older brother.
Yeah. No, he will.
A good prospect.
This is Roebuck, number 5, his father, I coached him in baseball when he played Connie Mack ball for Dotco. And then he had a pro career of several years.
Wow. Good ball movement from the Bears. Their coach, Blake Rocky. Of course, John Deal coaching the Aces.
Off the bucket. Colby Lockoff.
4-2. Aces freshmen are down a couple tonight. They only have 6 dressed, so not a lot of substitution for Hicksville this evening.
Ooh, nice play. And got it.
Yeah. Langham.
Colby Lockoff again.
Miller takes it across the timeline. Aces get their offense set. Sullivan loses it. It's scooped up off the floor by Zuber. Zuber, quick transition from the corner. It's a long shot by Pelland. And over our first whistle of the night.
Yes, over the back foul on Tunis. No doubt. Roebuck inbound it to Brown. Brooks Brown. His father used to be the baseball coach at Bryan. I know these guys pretty well from umpiring. Roebuck with a shot from 15, no good. Aces with the board.
Pull-up jumper just short. Off the front of the iron, and quickly all alone under the hoop, and he misses the easy two.
Just the bunny.
Outside the three-point arc.
And short.
Colby Lockoff tried to between the legs dribble and almost got called for the travel, and the ball got stuck between his thighs. Fake move and a nice shot from Zuber.
4 points for him. 8-4 the score. Bryan with the lead and a driving layup.
And that was Miller puts it down. Fast moving first quarter. Of course, only 6 minute quarters at the freshman level, so.
Brown, Roebuck with the ball in the lane. Hands it off. Shot partially blocked.
Slapped out of bounds. That's touched by the Golden Bears.
Jackson and Arthur into the game for Bryan. Roebuck comes out along with Lockoff. Nope, not Lockoff. Pellard.
Nice pass to the scoring table.
Jabo with his quick hands.
Sullivan get ready to handle the inbounds for the Aces.
Tunis in the corner. Shot knocked away.
Still loose.
Picked up.
Sullivan grabbed it, I think.
Another drive to the hoop, and he's going to be fouled. Miller going to shoot a pair.
You can tell these are the freshmen. The Aces have the right idea, but they're just a little bit slow in executing some of the ball exchanges on offense.
It's early. Very.
Miller off the back of the iron. Got the second one. 3 points for Jacob. Nice pass. A good look and a nice shot down low. Right to Arthur, who puts it up and in.
Ten second call.
Be a travel. Yep.
Yes, it was.
Drug the pivot foot a little bit. About a half a minute to go here in this first quarter.
Tunis to Bland. Bland gets the ball knocked away, and we're going to have a foul on the aggressor.
You reach in.
22. Lockoff.
That's his second.
Ooh, it's give and go.
They'll send Tunis to the line for a pair.
Got fouled by Reese.
So our first look at Travian Tunis at the free throw line.
Yeah, it's good.
Pulls the Aces back to within a couple.
Second is good.
Well, they're giving him one more.
What are they doing?
I'm not sure.
No kidding.
Okay. Well, they're not changing the score, though, so.
That's unreal.
I think it might have been a lane violation, so. But he hit all three of them, so. Yep. Only two of them count, but yep. That's okay. Long three.
Aces are on top, 10-9. Shot missed at the horn by.
End of the first quarter. Bears with a 1-point lead, 10-9. We've got a quarter break here, so we'll take a little time to say a big thank you to our basketball broadcast underwriters once again for the 2016-17 basketball season, the Jim Schmidt family of automotive dealerships in Hicksville, Ohio, both Jim Schmidt Chevrolet and Jim Schmidt Ford with us once again for all of our basketball coverage here on Hicksville Community Television, boys and girls from the junior high all the way up through the varsity level. I want to thank them so very much. And quick reminder that snow had you worried about your vehicle's performance. You can get your car winterized and ready to go for the cold months ahead at the service departments at Jim Schmidt Chevrolet Buick and Jim Schmidt Ford in Hicksville, Ohio. And everything you need to know is online at jimschmidtauto.com. Playing pretty even in that first 6 minutes, Jim. A little rough around the edges. You can tell the younger kids, not a lot of game experience under their belts yet, but...
Well, they'll get there. Yeah. Pretty evenly matched. Yeah. Two teams here.
Yeah, we don't have a... There's not a huge height advantage on either side, and... I mean, Reese Jackson has some good height for Bryan, but he's matched up pretty well with Braden Langham for the Aces, so.
Sullivan with the ball. On the outside, Langham brings it around to Wilhelm. Langham in the lane. Bland with the ball. Down to 10, passes it out. And the ball is stolen.
And knocked loose to go out of bounds.
Arthur was the culprit.
He read the pass really well and stepped right in front of it, but tripped on his feet a little bit.
Milton. Ooh, down low.
Oh.
Nice reverse. Bland with the reverse.
Yeah, his first points of the night. Aces with a 1 point lead now, 11-10. And a steal.
He got fouled and made the bucket. A little bit of push in the back.
So Langham looks to see if he can make it a 4 point lead for the Aces. And as Lockhoff checks back in for Bryan. And Jackson will have a seat.
Langham short, gets his rebound, puts it up from 10. It's good.
We'll take it.
6 points for Langham.
And
15-10 to score, and Brian's going to take a timeout.
And as we mentioned, this is the first of three here tonight. Golden Bears are in town. They'll be this freshman matchup, and then the varsity, and well, the JV, and then the varsity that we'll have for you. You can check the channel guide. They'll all be featured here on HIX-TV. Last night's freshman game was canceled because of the winter weather. The Aces would have been available to play, but Antwerp canceled their school day, so they put the freshman game by the wayside on Monday. And it's good to be back here in the red zone, our first chance to see the Aces in action for this basketball season. Tipped away, but scooped back up by Bryan.
Ooh. Shot up Roebuck over his top. And
oh, that's a nice
that
move.
Was Roebuck. That was Arthur. Connor Arthur.
Now Arthur sort of wove his way through the traffic there and got a tough shot to fall.
Timeout. Hicksville saved a 10-second count.
Mm-hmm. I thought they were going to get him, too.
Brian's coach thought, for sure.
Yeah. 15 to 12 here in this freshman game as we're in the second quarter. Ace has been playing pretty well. They've only committed one foul so far. The Bears have racked up four.
So the Aces are pretty aggressive with the ball.
And they're... I've got them down for a total of three out of four from the free throw line, or four out of five.
Three out of five. Pass down low, off plan. Nope, it's off Bryan.
Lucky break for the Aces. Nope. Sullivan. Trying hard to get that reach in.
Yeah. He was working on it.
Don't blow the whistle on him. And
Nice pass inside and shot. Easy money was missed.
Just bounced right along the hoop and would not go down for him.
Miller with the ball out front. Wilhelm in the corner to Bland. Bland into the lane. Eight-footer, no good, but he's fouled.
And that's going to be on number 12, Pelland. Picks up his first.
Free throw is good. Second also. Yeah. 4 points for Bland. 17-12, Hicksville to lead. Pass in the corner. Lock of stop. That called. We have a foul. 14, Langham.
That's Braden's first. That'll be a common foul. On the floor.
Oh, he missed him on the backside. Had an easy shot. Lockoff down to Roebuck, and he's going to be fouled on the shot. Miller picks up the foul.
Up to three team fouls now on the Aces with 2:47 to go before halftime.
Missed the first. That's the first shot from the free throw line for Bryan. Got the second.
Got the second.
17-13. Hicksville leading. Freshman game here at the red zone. Wilhelm comes up with the ball. Bland cut off the free throw line. Back out, Langham. Sullivan from outside is no good. Bryan with the rebound. Lockoff bringing the ball up. Pass down low to Roebuck.
Yep,
shots in and out. Rebound to Wilhelm.
Full court pressure from the Bears.
Bryan's pressure doesn't seem to be bothering the young Aces.
Nope.
Wilhelm from the corner, it's no good, and Bland is going to get called for over the back.
That'll be Bland's first, and foul number four on the Aces.
Oh, you traveled.
Aces is using that really swarming, very aggressive defense down there. And
yeah, they're not standing around, are they? See, once again, that press didn't stop, and we made a mistake down low after we get it across there. Throw buck on the give and go, and off his hand and out of bounds. They have a block and foul on Jackson for Bryan.
That's number two for Reese. He'll come out for a bit.
1 minute exactly to go in the first half. Oh, that's a nice play. A little bit long on the rim.
Miller was slapping his hands going, I can't believe I missed it.
Yep. Arthur gets blocked by the rim. Going too deep on that one. Oh, we're going to have 20 with the foul. It is so easy to referee from the stands.
Yep. Got that good look at everything that's going on.
Yeah.
Zuber picks up his first. And that's number seven, so that'll put the Aces into the bonus for the last 40 seconds, 41.6 seconds of this half.
Got one.
And the free throws have made a difference in this first half.
Yes, they have. Got two.
Hits them both.
Lockoff with the ball to Roebuck. Back to Lockoff. Puts up the jumper. No good. Roebuck with the board. Goes inside, he's short on the shot, but is fouled. Bland gets the personal.
It's Gabe's second, and he'll shoot two. Sends Benny Roebuck to the line. Got that one.
2 points for him. Three.
Right. He'll up his free throw percentage to 75%
with
that one.
From 50. Yeah, gonna get called for travel.
Yep. 16.5 seconds before the half. Aces up by four.
Ball comes around to Roebuck. Roebuck looks. Zuber. Short. Bland the rebound. And that'll be the end of that. 19-15, Aces lead at the end of the first half. Freshman game here at the Red Zone tonight. We'll be back with the second half.
Well, welcome back as we're getting ready to get the second half underway here in this freshman game. And if you are joining us right now, our halftime score, it's the Aces leading the Bryan Golden Bears. The score 19-15. Unofficial scoring in the first half doesn't take a lot to run through it. For the Golden Bears, 4 points each in the first half for Caleb Zuber, Colby Lockoff, and Connor Arthur, all of them hitting two field goals, and then three free throws for Benny Roebuck and 3 points. And add those together, that's 15. For the Aces, leading all scorers tonight, Braden Langham with 3 field goals for 6 points in the first half. Jacob Miller had a field goal and 3 free throws for 5. A field goal and 2 free throws for 4 points for both Travian Tunis and for Gabe Bland. And that pretty much wraps up the scoring. Reese Jackson and Colby Lockoff with a couple of fouls each on the Golden Bears side. And Gabe Bland, the only ace with more than a single infraction in the first half. So that's the quick rundown. And again, at halftime, Aces leading the Bears 19-15. And kind of excited to see the JV and the varsity if they're going to keep this scrappy style that the freshmen are using here tonight, Jim. They've been really aggressive going after the ball, and they've handled the Golden Bears' pressure really well, and managed to get their fair share of turnovers, and really did a pretty good job playing in that first half.
Yeah, they're playing even field goal wise. The Aces are pulling out the free throws. They have the lead on them.
Yeah, they only sent Bryan to the line twice, I think, in the entire first half.
They were 3 for 4. Mm-hmm. We were 5, 6, 7, 7 out of 9. So that's your lead more.
Yep. Basically, it's the free throws.
Yep. And a drive and lay in by Brown for Bryan. And steals the ball and goes the other way. Gets another. 4 quick points for Brooks Brown. Oh. Bland, shot short. Flip back in, and Bryan comes out with it. Down the floor quickly. And shot is put up by Palland, and he is fouled. And we'll get a pair.
Tap Tunis. That'll be his second personal.
And we have a 30-second timeout called by the Aces.
John Deal. Dave Blue going to talk things over. Sparse crowd here, but it is early on in the evening, and I figure more folks will be trickling in for the junior varsity and the varsity matchup.
Yeah, and a lot of these people will trickle out.
Yeah.
The freshman parents.
They'll be done, and unless they've got a sibling playing later tonight.
Yep.
And the varsity's just
Bryan's
coming
just
in.
Bryan's just arrived.
Yeah. Have an early start to this freshman game, 4:30 in the afternoon. To get it in and be able to have that 20-minute break before they get the junior varsity game started at about 6. High arc for Pelland and goes off the back of the iron. There we go. That's his first point of the night. And that gives the Bears a 1-point lead.
Oh, nice pass, and Bland couldn't handle it, and it went off his foot out of bounds. He was all by himself under there.
So Bryan looking to add to the lead. It did not take them long to cut and erase that deficit.
Have a foul on the floor.
Be Travian Tunis is third.
Jumper put up, missed. Rebound comes off to Sullivan. Miller across the 10-second line. Tunis in the lane, shot up, no good.
No, okay.
Yeah, I'll take it. Pass it to me, I'll take it.
I don't think he meant the bounce pass to go right to Bland, but
he happened to be there.
Grab it. Jump ball.
Jump ball.
It should go to the Aces.
They reciprocated with a bad pass.
Yep.
And the bucket by Lockoff, and he's fouled. Aces could use some points here. They haven't scored this half. Free throw is good.
Good.
7 points for Lockoff and a steal by the Bears.
Is that Arthur, number 25, that got us, Jim?
It was Lockoff.
Okay.
Now Arthur's at the wing.
This is the first one.
And the second. Tunis with the rebound.
Tunis is going to have to watch himself. Four fouls on him. Arthur steals it away.
Wilhelm with the ball to Miller. Miller baseline. Reverse layup. Doesn't get there. Down the floor to Jackson. Gets 2 points.
His first bucket of the night.
And a steal. And a foul.
Wow.
Steal by Arthur.
Back in the middle of it again.
Yep.
Has not been able to get the ball to drop yet from the free throw line.
Yeah,
there he goes.
26-19, Golden Bears with the lead here in the third quarter with 3 to go remaining.
Nice
pass. Brown with the lay-in.
And another timeout because this second half has been like night and day.
Yes.
As the Bears have shook off whatever it was that they woke themselves up. And in a lot of ways, it's almost like they took a page out of the Aces book in that first half, and they're the ones now that are using the quick hands and the swarming. And they've been giving the aces fits. And, of course, aces with just six guys dressed tonight. And with Travian Tunis with four fouls, they don't have a lot of options should Tunis foul out. They've been holding Langham back, and I think they were kind of hoping that maybe give him some eligibility for the junior varsity game. But
yes.
Get back into action here. And the full court pressure.
It's starting to bother him now.
A little bit, yeah.
Yeah. Miller out front. Sullivan. To Wilhelm. To Bland. And we're going to have a foul on number 10, Bryan Brown. Oh, stop.
That'll be on the floor. Common foul.
Reyes
that's
in
Brown's
the game now.
First. Five team fouls on the aces and only one committed by Bryan so far.
Jackson and the ball is picked up by Brown up the floor. Reyes with the ball.
Hello. Oh, nobody home.
Yep. Threw the ball behind his ear.
Almost stolen away, goes out of bounds. And that's Arthur again.
They fed him some wake up in the locker room. Ball picked up down the floor, and Tuna steps in front of it. Getting a little ragged out there right now.
Yes, indeed. Sullivan.
Off
just inside.
Shot. Doesn't get there. Brown with the ball up the floor.
90 seconds left in quarter number three.
Jackson in the lane, lays it up, and it's good.
Good looking shot from Reese Jackson. Put the Golden Bears up by 11 off of Wilhelm's hands and out of bounds. Bryan's going to take a timeout.
30 seconds.
I think that's maybe Coach Rocky wanted to make sure that they don't get too out of control, because it's getting to the point now where the pace has picked up so much in this game that you could easily get to the point where you're playing faster than you're actually able to play. And
yes.
Having things spin out of control that way, so get the team a little bit of a break and refocused.
That's why I said that it looked like they were getting a little ragged out there. And
Reyes will bring it up for Bryan.
Oh, you trapped.
Yep. Trying to get the ball under control and took that extra step.
Bryan getting a few extra different people on the floor now. Letting starters rest, I believe, for JV action. Miller puts up an off-balance shot. It's rebounded by Jackson. Into the lane. From outside, oop. It's
in and out.
Zuber. Miller picks it up. Sullivan with the tried to get it inside to Bland.
Right now, Jackson is using his height to good advantage, and he's clogging up those passing lanes.
Shot from outside, no good. Shot by Reyes inside is blocked. And we're going to have a foul called. And 22 of Bryan.
Lockoff's third, I believe. Team foul number two for Bryan. 22.9 seconds left in the quarter.
Oh, nice move by Miller. Tunis. Sullivan. Oh, again.
Land turned the... He turned right and the ball went left.
Yeah, didn't anticipate him going towards the basket. Reyes on Miller.
We're going to run out of time.
That was a little late.
And what a third quarter as the Bears just came out and...
Shut out the Aces.
Yeah, they put up basically 11 unanswered points in the third quarter to lead 30-19. Our freshman basketball coverage on Hicks TV brought to you by our good friends at the Jim Schmidt family of automotive dealerships in Hicksville, Ohio, Jim Schmidt Chevrolet Buick and Jim Schmidt Ford. And we always like to remind you that if you're in the market for a vehicle, either brand spanking new or previously owned, be it a car, truck, van, or SUV, check out the great selection they have on the lots of the Jim Schmidt family of automotive dealerships. Either stop by in person at the Ford or the Chevrolet Buick dealership, or you can check out their entire inventory online at jimschmidtauto.com. So glad and proud to have them once again underwriting all of our basketball coverage for the 2016-17 school year. The Jim Schmidt family of automotive dealerships in Hicksville, Ohio, and online at jimschmidtauto.com.
Bryan actually outscored him 15-0.
Oh, that's right, because they had to make up the deficit.
Yeah.
You're right.
Bryan will be inbounding the ball, and Adam Fireovid. His father was the pitcher for Bryan in 1974 or 5 that won the state championship, and he pitched all but one inning in the whole way through the tournament.
Mm-hmm.
Nice rebound by him. 2 points, first one's for Fireovid. Mm-hmm.
Long pass down to Bland, and knocked out of bounds.
That's when you jump stop and leave him fly by you.
And Langham back in the game as well for the Aces after sitting out the entire third quarter.
That gives him 2 quarters for the JV
yep.
game. Tunis sat out the second quarter, so he has two. Wilhelm thought he had two pivot feet.
Yeah, you can't twist on one and then plant the other and then twist on that one. It doesn't work that way.
No. Down low to Robach. Oh. It's good.
5 points now for Robach.
Yep. Nice block. Robach picks up the loose ball. Pass down low to
off the
Arthur.
Pass and good for Arthur. 7 points now for Connor.
There you go.
Yeah.
Land gets the layup.
Land off the glass and good.
6 points for him.
And that's the first 2 points of
yep.
this second half.
It broke the ice. Robach baseline picks it back. Ball loose on the floor, Brown, and we're going to have a jump ball.
And that should go to Aces, okay.
Cooley's on the floor finally, so he'll play in the JV game.
Lost the dribble and it gets slapped out of bounds.
Rebound pulled off by Cooley. Quickly down for Roebuck. Down low. Puts it up off the glass.
Strong move from Roebuck.
Seven for him.
Langham has his pocket picked. And then a
trip. Roebuck's going to pick up layup. And good.
Got it.
6 quick points by Roebuck.
He's just shy of double figures now. 9 total for the game. So, when all was said and done on that, they called the Aces for a travel.
Yeah, and they called it
over and back, too, I think I saw.
And Bryan was the one that threw the ball to Bryan player. Yeah.
And, okay. Cooley loses the ball, slapped out by Langham. Get it inbound to Arthur.
Fire over, gives him back.
Oh.
Arthur lays it in. 9 points for Arthur.
He could go into double figures here.
I have another timeout. This time it's Hicksville.
Yeah, the Aces were holding their own in that first half, but whatever Coach Rocky said in the locker room at halftime had its desired effect. That plus, I said we kind of were figuring. We knew who was going to be playing in the JV game or who they wanted to have available. They kind of mothballed them. They didn't take off their warm-up jacket, their warm-up shirts during that entire first half.
You're right. And a couple of them came in the third quarter and a couple more in the fourth quarter.
And it's made the difference. So really, I guess not a bad strategy if you can sideline your three or four best players and hold your opponent fairly close in the first half, and then you can turn them loose in quarters 3 and 4.
Yep.
It's worked for Bryan here tonight.
Kind of puts the coach in a bad position because the coach that's just over him, the JV coach, is the one that's asking him to do that. In fact, asking isn't necessarily the word. Free throw missed by Arthur. Langham
loses the ball
off his foot.
The last touch by the Aces. Oh, I take it back. You're going to give it to Hicksville?
Give it to
All
us.
Right. I thought it went off Langham's foot.
I did too. Jackson back in the game. Cooley's going to sit.
So with that, they'll switch personnel around and change the inbounds person. Lands bounce pass along the baseline. Intercepted by Reyes. Goes out of bounds. Just under 3 minutes left in this contest. Aces down by 21.
Double dribble.
Carried the ball.
You drug your foot.
Thank you. So we'll reset it again. Oh, it would have been great if he'd just been a foot over.
Yeah, good idea.
It was. Kick it back out. Byrovid hands it off to Reyes. Reyes is going to draw the foul. Put him into the bonus. Wilhelm picks up his second. And it'll be 1-1 for Reyes. Ooh.
Second one rebounded by Langham. Quick play to Tunis. Tunis in the lane.
And traveled. Zuvro will take it out onto the top of the key. Bryan can take their time running their offense now.
Jackson with the ball. Fire over. Off the foot. And it'll be Bryan ball.
Zuber gets the ball taken away by Langham.
He's quick.
There we go.
Langham down the floor quickly. 8 points for Langham.
Under a minute now.
Reyes just dribbling the ball.
Yep.
Zuber into the lane, puts up the jumper.
Oh, good. He'll go to the line. It'll be number 3 on Bland. But net for Zuber.
5 for him. And 6. Tunis baseline puts it up short. Jackson with the rebound. Fire over down floor. Oh. Put off the glass by 32, Kimple.
Kimple.
His first 2 points of the night.
It's his name in the scorebook.
Yes, Cooley's the only one from Bryan that hasn't yet anything.
3 from Tunis is no good. And a few dribbles, and that's going to be all she wrote.
Yes, it is. 47-23, the final score. Give you the scoring. I'll give you Bryan or Hicksville's real quick. 2 for Tunis. Have 7 for Miller. Have 8 for Langham. and Bland had 6 for their total of 23.
And for the Aces?
No, for Bryan.
Or for Bryan, excuse me. They were led, nobody in double figures, but a couple of Golden Bears scoring 9 tonight. Roebuck, who only had 3 in the first half, sank 3 field goals in the second half for 6 additional for 9. And also Connor Arthur had 4 field goals and a free throw for 9 points. After that, it was 6 points tonight for Brooks Brown and for Caleb Zuver, 7 points for Kobe Lockhoff. And then, well, let's see, 4 points for Reese Jackson tonight. 2 points for both Adam Fireovid and Max Kimple, and then a point apiece for Reyes and for Pelland. And that will wrap everything up in 47-23 as the Aces are dominated in the second half of this freshman game by the Bryan Golden Bears. So that's going to wrap up our game one of tonight's basketball triple header. And again, I want to say a big thank you to the Jim Schmidt family of automotive dealerships, Jim Schmidt Chevrolet Buick, Jim Schmidt Ford, and of course online, jimschmidtauto.com, for helping to underwrite our basketball coverage for you this evening. And with that, we're going to take a bit of a break, but we invite you to stay tuned to Hicksville Community Television. We'll have coverage coming your way of the junior varsity and the varsity contest tonight between the Golden Bears and the Aces from here at the Red Zone. But with that, we're going to draw it to a close. One last time in this freshman basketball game, your final score from the Red Zone, it's the Bryan Golden Bears defeating the Hicksville Aces 47-23. For Kate Murphy on the camera with assistance from Summer Powell here tonight. And for Jim Seiler, I'm Bill Murphy for Hicksville Community Television, wishing you good night and good sports.